Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, as you heard, my name is Fatima Hussein. I work at the Ministry of Environment, Water and Natural Resources. And I'm also a climate change negotiator at the UNFCCC process. So I come here, first of all, presenting the Adaptation Fund Board in this meeting, and I'll be making a few remarks on behalf of the Adaptation Fund Board, as well as receiving the declarations and presenting the Government of Kenya in this conference. So I'll wear into that. So first of all, we want to sincerely thank you for choosing Kenya as the host of the CBA conference. And for this opportunity, first of all, according to the Adaptation Fund, to share experiences relating to the view of the fund on the specific topic which was under discussion at this conference. This conference provides an excellent opportunity for us to share our experiences and deliver the key messages, as you have done today, to key processes that are ongoing, and we very much welcome that. From the Adaptation Fund's point of view, as you know, the Adaptation Fund provides funding and resources to implementation of concrete adaptation projects in projects and programs in developing countries. The fund is governed by a board with a large part of the representation of that board being from developing countries. Since its operationalization in 2010, the fund has approved more than 47 projects and programs in over 40 countries that are ongoing, and implementation of these projects are actually ongoing at this point in time. You can see all the details of what the fund is doing currently to save on time. I will quickly share with you the experience in our country here in Kenya from the National Environment Management Authority, which has been accredited by the fund in 2012 as a national implementing entity. And this experience has been very, very important for us because it took the institution that was nominated by the government through processes of accreditation and later on developing projects and a bigger program for the country, which had been later approved by the board and fund already released to the National Environment Management Authority. At the moment, the fund is the implementing entity in Kenya. Is doing very well, and implementation has actually started, and preparations to put together all the policy documents that are required before the real implementation starts is ongoing with NEMA. What has been the experience from NEMA engagement with the Adaptation Fund? A key lesson was that national institutions need to be facilitated and capacities built in national institutions so that they can undertake these projects and programs on adaptation. And we need extensive community and stakeholders participation in this programming process. This process has enabled Kenya to actually not just focusing on the Adaptation Fund itself, but look out for other resources that can help the country access funding for adaptation from various quarters, one of them being the Green Climate Fund. And NEMA is currently undergoing a fast-track accreditation process under the Green Climate Fund. So you can see being accredited through the Adaptation Fund has built the capacity of the national institution and has engaged, and I think more than 10 institutions at the local level are actually implementing some of the activities in this program, which is coordinated by NEMA. So from that experience, I would want to say, first of all, relating to the theme of the conference, measuring and enhancing effective evaluation, adaptation would require that you respond to the national and local needs of communities and local stakeholders. That is where you get the key adaptation responses that are required, which would vary from one local place to the other. I guess what is happening and what is being implemented in Bangladesh is totally different from how we see adaptation activities here in Kenya, and specifically in different counties. Secondly, lessons learning and sharing experience would be critical for us to be able to effectively monitor and measure adaptation effects, which is the key challenge that the global community is currently trying to discuss and see a way forward of how do we come up with a global framework or a system that would help the global community as a whole to measure adaptation. And I think this conference would go a long way providing useful inputs to that international processes as well. Enhanced funding would be required. We are told by the scientific community that adaptation would continue to increase, the requirements for adaptation would continue to increase, therefore we need more money for adaptation. And I'm happy to note that we are moving now away from the traditional public resources for adaptation, which would be critical, but then exploring other opportunities, and I think that was a key message that has been delivered, that we need to engage the private sector. We need to leverage private sector financing for adaptation initiatives, which we very much support. The other thing is that we will need not just projects and programs being prepared and implemented, but we need institutions at the national and sub-national level to be able to take forward these programs. Therefore, the capacities of these institutions need to be built. I would briefly encourage all of you, you would see and I was told that the video was also presented on what the experience has been on the national implementing entities of the Adaptation Fund, and you can look at what the experience has been, what programs and projects are being proposed by your specific governments through their national implementing entities, and through some governments have opted for multilateral implementing entities. You can see and interact with them as you go along, and I will encourage also the youth to do that. On the other side, as I now move to as a representative of the government of Kenya, first of all, I want to convey the apologies of the principal secretaries and the cabinet secretary who was not able to be here with you. We very much support this conference. That's why the cabinet secretary was here at the opening, and there was commitment to her to be here at the closing, but that was not possible due to other engagements that are very challenging for them to be here. On behalf of the Government of Kenya, the National Organizing Committee, which we were part of, and the Ministry of Environment and Natural Resources, it's been great hosting all of you here in Nairobi, and specifically at this particular venue. And we feel the conference has provided a lot of interesting and useful information that we will need to take forward on this particular issue, which is priority for us as the Government of Kenya. And for us, I think it is really touching when you talk about community involvement and community-based adaptation. It's really something that touches most of us, because we have seen over the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about drought and the kind of problems we have with the food that is not available in many parts of the country because of the droughts that were there. But currently, people are being swept away, so many Kenyans have died, and therefore this is really touching, and we need to do a lot in terms of implementing specific community level adaptation activities. And therefore we find the key outcomes and the experiences shared from this conference as useful as we prepare our own national adaptation activities and processes as a government. And we will continue to ensure that communities and youths are part and parcel of these processes. We also recognize the youth conference that took place here, and we are happy to also receive the declaration both from the youth and from this CBA conference, and we will take forward some of the key messages, not just to our national processes, but rather at the international scene as in our own capacities as parties, and as well, most of the messages that are coming, particularly from the CBA conference, are things that we can go along as the African continent and rally behind, and actually all the other developing countries vulnerable to the climate change, we can all present this, particularly in the process that we, as negotiators, have been participating in, and we're happy to take that forward. The other issue is the other outcomes that have been outlined. We know the conference has presented a number of other outcomes. We will be happy to take forward. And I want to assure you that the government of Kenya completely support this CBA conference and processes, as well as the outcome that has emanated from this conference. And secondly, we are happy to note that you have also gone out there, seen specific community activities that Kenyans are undertaking, and we will be happy to share our experience with others as well, as well as go out there and share what is going on with other communities out there as we participate in the next series of CBA conferences. Particularly, it is important for us to note that, you know, the system of governance that we have in place, county governments are being involved and sensitized on this process, I think, has been a key positive outcome of this conference that we very much appreciate the presence of the council, the chair of the Committee on Environment and Natural Resources being here with us today. We very much appreciate as government that this CBA conference has gone a long way, ensuring that all the two levels of government are very much well involved in this process. Thank you very much, and have a very nice day here in Nairobi, as well as others who would have an opportunity to go out there. Much has been said about Kenya, but Kenya is still very peaceful. Please go out there and enjoy yourself. Thank you. Thank you.